Sunday, 8th week after Pentecost, evening meditation, July 18th, 2021. Meditations are taken from Meditations and Readings for Every Day of the Year by St. Alphonsus Liguori, Bishop and Doctor of the Church, First Choices Teacher in Moral Theology, Act of Faith in the Presence of God, in Nomina Patri, et Filii, et Spiritus Sancti. Amen. Most Holy, Adorable, and Undivided Trinity, one God in three persons, I believe that Thou art here present. I adore Thee with the deepest humility, and render to Thee with my whole heart the homage which is due to Thy Sovereign Majesty. Grant me the grace to pray as I ought. Speak, Lord, for Thy servant heareth. O Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God and my Mother, I ask for the grace to continue to pray. St. Alphonsus Liguori, pray for us. Christian soul, reflect on these every day of your life. There is one God to glorify, one eternity to prepare for, saints and angels to call upon, one life to use well, one body to mortify, one death to suffer, one hell to avoid, one judgment to confront, one Jesus to imitate, one soul to save, neighbors to edify, one world to be detached from, sins to expiate for, passions to subject to our will, virtues to acquire, one heaven to win. Act of humility, litany of humility, O Jesus, meek and humble of heart, hear me. From the desire of being esteemed, deliver me, Jesus. From the desire of being loved, deliver me, Jesus. From the desire of being extolled, deliver me, Jesus. From the desire of being honored, deliver me, Jesus. From the desire of being praised, deliver me, Jesus. From the desire of being preferred to others, deliver me, Jesus. From the desire of being consulted, deliver me, Jesus. From the desire of being approved, deliver me, Jesus. From the fear of being humiliated, deliver me, Jesus. From the fear of being despised, deliver me, Jesus. From the fear of suffering rebukes, deliver me, Jesus. From the fear of being calumniated, deliver me, Jesus. From the fear of being forgotten, deliver me, Jesus. From the fear of being ridiculed, deliver me, Jesus. From the fear of being wronged, deliver me, Jesus. From the fear of being suspected, deliver me, Jesus. That others may be loved more than I, Jesus, grant me the grace to desire it. That others may be esteemed more than I, Jesus, grant me the grace to desire it. That in the opinion of the world, others may increase and I may decrease. Jesus, grant me the grace to desire it. That others may be chosen and I set aside. Jesus, grant me the grace to desire it. That others may be praised and I unnoticed. Jesus, grant me the grace to desire it. That others may be preferred to me in everything. Jesus, grant me the grace to desire it. That others may become holier than I, provided that I may become as holy as I should. Jesus, grant me the grace to desire it. Almighty God, Father, Son, Holy Ghost, we ask for your guidance in this our evening meditation through the intercession of thy blessed mother, Mary, ever virgin. Ave Maria, gratia plena Dominus tecum. Benedicta tu in mulieribus, benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus. Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc in hora mortis nostrae. Amen. In honor of Saint Joseph, our guardian angel, and all the saints, we pray, Gloria Patri, Filio, Spiritus Sancto, sicut erat in principio, nunc et semper, in saecula saeculorum. Amen. Come, Holy Ghost, fill the hearts of thy faithful, and kindle in them the fire of thy love. Send forth thy Spirit, and it shall be created, and you shall renew the face of the earth. Let us pray. O God, who did instruct the hearts of the faithful by the light of the Holy Ghost, grant in that same Spirit that we may be truly wise, ever to rejoice in his consolation through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. Evening meditation, the practice of the love of Jesus Christ. Charity endureth all things. He that loves Jesus Christ with a strong love does not cease to love him in the midst of temptations and desolations. Let's come now to the means which we have to employ in order to vanquish temptations. Spiritual masters prescribe a variety of means, but the most necessary and the safest, of which only I will here speak, is to have immediate recourse to God with all humility and confidence, saying, quote, incline unto my aid, O God, O Lord, make haste to help me. This short prayer will enable us to overcome the assaults of all the devils of hell, for God is infinitely more powerful than all of them. Almighty God knows well that of ourselves, we are unable to resist the temptations of the infernal powers. And on this account, the most learned Cardinal Gotti remarks that, quote, whenever we are assailed and in danger of being overcome, God is obliged to give us strength enough to resist as often as we call upon him for it, unquote. And how can we doubt receiving help from Jesus Christ after all the promises he has made us in the Holy Scriptures? quote, "Come to me, all you that labor and are heavily laden, and I will refresh you." Matthew 11:28. "Come to me, ye who are wearied and fighting against temptations, and I will restore your strength." Quote, "Call upon me in the day of trouble, and I will deliver thee, and thou shalt glorify me." Psalm 49:15. "When thou seest thyself troubled by thy enemies, call upon me, and I will bring thee out of danger, and thou shalt praise me. Then shalt thou call, and the Lord shall hear. Thou shalt cry, and he shall say," quote, "Here I am." Isaiah 58:9. "Then shalt thou call upon the Lord for help, and he will hear thee. And thou shalt cry out, quick, O Lord, help me. And he will say to thee, behold, here I am, I am present to help thee." Quote, "Who hath called upon him, and he despised him?" Ecclesiastes 2:12. "And who," says the prophet, "has ever called upon God, and God has despised him, and given him no help?" David felt sure of never falling a prey to his enemies, whilst he could have recourse to God. He says, quote, "Praising, I will call upon the Lord, and I shall be saved from my enemies." Psalm 17:4. "For he well knew that God is close to all who invoke his aid." Quote, "The Lord is nigh unto all them that call upon him." Psalm 144:18. And St. Paul adds that the Lord is by no means sparing, but lavish of graces towards all them that pray to him. Quote, "Rich unto all that call upon him." Romans 10:12. Oh, would to God that all men had recourse to him whenever they are tempted to offend him. They would then certainly never commit sin. They unhappily fall because, led away by the cravings of their vicious appetites, they prefer to lose God, the sovereign good, than to forgo their wretched, short-lived pleasures. Experience gives us manifest proofs that whoever calls on God in temptation does not fall, and whoever fails to call on him as surely falls. And this is especially true of temptations to impurity. Solomon himself said that he knew very well that he could not be chaste unless God gave him the grace to be so. And therefore he invoked him by prayer in the moment of temptation. Quote, "And as I knew that I could not otherwise be continent except God gave it, I went to the Lord and besought him." Wisdom 8:21. In temptations against purity, and the same holds good with regard to those against faith, we must take it as a rule never to stay and combat the temptation hand to hand, but we must endeavor immediately to get rid of it indirectly by making a good act of love, of the love of God, or of sorrow for our sins, or else by applying ourselves to some indifferent occupation calculated to distract us. As soon as we discover a thought of evil tendency, we must disown it immediately, and so to speak, close the door in its face, and deny it all entrance into the mind, without tearing in the least to examine its object or errand. We must cast away these foul suggestions as quickly as we would shake off a hot spark from the fire. Concluding prayer, "I give you thanks, O God, Father, Son, and Holy Ghost, for the light which thou now bestowest upon me. I make a firm purpose of my will, that I may, in uniformity with your divine will, O triune God, keep my resolutions, and keep them well, for the love of thee and thy mother, the Blessed Virgin Mary, so that through her intercession I may receive by her loving hands the grace to be ever faithful to my resolutions, my state in life and rule of life, now until the hour of my death. I give thee thanks, O God, for the patience with which thou hast hitherto borne with me. I see that, although I forgot thee, thou didst not forget me. I am sorry, my sovereign good, for having turned my back upon thee, and I am now resolved to give myself entirely to thee. And why should I delay that thou mayest abandon me, and that death may find me as miserable and grateful as I've been, even until now? No, my God, I will no more offend thee, but will love thee. I love thee, O infinite goodness. Give me perseverance and thy holy love. I ask for nothing more. Mary, refuge of sinners, intercede for all the holy souls in purgatory and for all poor sinners, particularly myself. In nomine Patris Filii Spiritus Sancti. Amen. Have a blessed evening, O slaves of Mary.